This is Jan Ashby, and today I want to give you some instruction on doing your images in your blog posts. This video will be regarding alternate text. It's regarding alt tag SEO, and I want to give you a little information first about the subject. It is worthwhile to include images in your blog posts. When you do, you should perform alt tag SEO. What you should do is use a new keyword every time you use an image in your post. Never use the same exact keyword phrase, however. If you're doing multiple images and in a single post, you want to change the name. Use a fresh keyword for each image. The reason for this is if you use the same title over and over again, it would be harmful to your SEO, and it'd be harmful ultimately to your rankings. Alright, now that we're clear on that, realize that the search engines, as smart as they are, do not inherently know the meaning of an image. Without some kind of metadata, Google is simply lost. Same for all the other search engines. Alright, now in choosing your image, you of course want to make sure to choose something that's relevant and that makes sense within the context of your post or article. Okay, now there are three things to do for your image. Number one, the file name. When you name the file, you're going to use your keyword. And the same for number two, title of the image. You're going to give it that same keyword name. And number three, where it says alternate text, you'll enter your keyword once again. All right, now, you upload it to your blog post with the specified keyword name and wait. Once you have named the file and it's all done uploading, all you have to do is enter a title, and then last of all, enter the alternate text. And this is exactly what it says, by the way, inside your WordPress dashboard. You click on the image and it'll say alternate text. Finally, after you've entered the alternate text, or alt text as some people call it, the search engines will now be able to comprehend what your image is about. This is beneficial. Why? Because it demonstrates that your blog post is relevant to a certain topic. This should help you in the rankings. And remember, you might get lucky and your image may also show up in Google image search. All right, that's about the end for this tutorial. Just one final note. Once you've published your blog post and you take a look at it, when you mouse over the image, you will see the title display. So be sure that you make the title a good one. This is Jan Ashby with info just for you. I'll see you in the next video.